After suffering a spinal cord injury and becoming a quadriplegic with not very good finger function or dexterity, it can be difficult to figure out how to use a mouse to control the cursor on a computer. In this video, I'm going to be showing you how I control the cursor on a computer using a mouse on a desktop and a touchpad on a laptop as a C5 through C7 quadriplegic with no finger function. I made a video showing how I type on a keyboard, and I had several people ask how I use a mouse. Let me know in the comments how you control the cursor on a computer and whether you use a special mouse or software, because I am interested to see what you use and how you use it. If you are new to the channel, my name is Mason Ellis and I am a C5 through C7 quadriplegic. I make videos to help you live life just like you would have able-bodied. If you enjoy this video, give it a like and subscribe to the channel so you don't miss out on future videos. The most common types of computer mice are wired, wireless, trackball, and touchpad. Although touchpads are mostly found on laptops, you can get touchpads that plug into any computer. There is also software that allows you to control the cursor with your head, eyes, or by speaking, which is beneficial to people that can't move their arms. I know there are some people that like using trackball mice to control the cursor on the computer, and trackball mice are pretty old. They've been around for a while, but there are some new ones, specifically from Logitech, and there will be links down in the description below for if you are interested in that. And I have never used one myself, so I can't comment on how it is as far as using it with not very good finger function. And then touchpad, you can get an external touchpad to plug in to your desktop or laptop or any computer, and I feel like that would be pretty beneficial to a lot of people. But personally, I do like wireless mice, and I am definitely not a fan of wired mice. Even before my accident, wireless is the way to go. I find wireless mice, such as this one, to be easier to use than wired mice because there isn't any cord that causes resistance when moving it around. The mouse that I use is a Logitech M510, which is easily my favorite mouse that I have used. It has an extremely long battery life, and I might change the batteries once a year, if that. And it does have these two buttons right here, which are forward and backward, but I never use them. If you are interested in this mouse, there is a link in the description of this video. When I first started using a computer after my accident, I was using a wireless mouse, and basically I would put my right hand up here, kind of toward the left of the left click, and then I would take my left hand and put it right here, and I would control the mouse like this, and it allowed me to be a lot more precise. Instead of just trying to use one hand and not being as accurate. However, after a while of using it like this, I was able to change. Basically, what I would do to use the mouse is use both hands and arms to move the mouse like this. Move my left arm as well as my right arm both. And then as far as clicking, I would use kind of the knuckle right here on my index finger and right here, somewhere in here for the right click. So I would kind of rotate my hand left and right like this. So left click would be like that and right click like that. So you can see right here, I am clicking the mouse, and then right click would be right here. And then sometimes you can just use your index finger to do right hand or right click or left click. And then as far as scrolling the scroll wheel, I would just use this part of my thumb and just do this. This worked for a while like this, but after a while I got to where I needed to have my my fingers over here on the keys as well as on the mouse at the same time, such as playing video games or something like that. So basically what I found to work was to just put like the top of the mouse right here, pretty much right here between my fingers and the bottom of my palm. I would just hold it like this, and this is how I move it around. And then as far as right clicking and left clicking, I would do this. So kind of clicks right in there for left click. And then right click, I would do right here. So same concept, but instead of having both hands like this, you would just have one hand and do it like that. As far as using the touchpad on a laptop, I will basically use my knuckle right here on my index finger to control the mouse, and I'll put my thumb right here on the edge, and it allows me to go up or back. Otherwise, your thumb is in the way. So that's why I rest it right here on the edge, and then you know you can go up, left, right like that. And then as far as clicking, I will use the index finger on my left hand and click this. So essentially it looks like this. I don't know if you can see that very well, but to move the mouse, I do this with my index finger on my right hand, and then to click, I will use the index finger on my left hand, and also you can use the index finger, the same index finger that you move the mouse with, but sometimes it's a lot quicker to do this, and then you can right click, left click, like that. But that is how I use a laptop touchpad. If you want to know how I type on a computer keyboard, check out my video on that. Don't forget to let me know in the comments how you control the cursor on a computer and whether you use a special mouse or software. If you enjoyed this video, give it a like and subscribe to the channel so you don't miss out on future videos. Thank you for watching this video, and I hope you watch another one of my videos.